Good morning, Gillsburg. We're so glad you could join us again this morning. We are so grateful that you follow our Facebook page or our YouTube channel and watch these videos. And we appreciate all of your likes and shares and comments, and we pray that you'll continue to do that in the upcoming weeks. A few announcements this morning before we turn it over to Brother Doug. I want to remind everyone that our senior recognition night is May the 31st, from 6 to 7. The way this will work is we'll have tables in the parking lot for each one of our seniors. And you can drive through in your vehicle to speak to each one of them and to congratulate them for graduating, and then drop off any card or gift that you would like to do so, and then pull on out of the parking lot. So it's a drive-through senior recognition night. And if you have any questions about that, you can text or call me, and I'll try to explain it to you the best I can. But that's May 31st from 6 to 7 p.m. in the church parking lot. Also, I want to remind you that the Nail Benders will be going to St. Francisville on June the 1st through June the 5th. RVs or camper trailers are welcome, and if you have any questions about that, please see Brother Tommy Smith. Also, our prayer list gets emailed each Wednesday. If you see of anything that needs to be updated on that list, we ask that you will email the church email address or call the church office number and leave a message and let us know whatever change we need to make, and we'll get that updated in our prayer list. Like every week, I want to encourage you to still reach out through text messages or calls or cards and stay in touch with your congregation or your Sunday school classes as much as you can. Also, I want to remind you that our website is up and going. You can give your tithe there, or you can text to the Gillsburg giving number to also give if that's convenient for you. I believe that's all of my announcements this morning, and now I'm going to turn it over to Brother Doug.
Thank you, Brother Austin. This morning we're going to be singing hymns about his provision for us. Before we start out, we're going to have a call to worship that we trust that you can worship through these telecasts that we do every week. And I know we do here in the church. And we just want to sing a song that says, "I rejoice with those who said to me, let us go to the house of the Lord. Let's all worship together from our hearts. We have come into his house." We have come into his house and gathered in his name to worship him. We have come into his house and gathered in his name to worship him. We have come into his house and gathered in his name to worship Christ the Lord. Worship him, Christ the Lord. And then we're singing the most important part. Let's forget about ourselves and magnify his name and worship him. Let's forget about ourselves and magnify his name and worship him. Let's forget about ourselves and magnify his name and worship Christ the Lord. Worship him, Christ. Brother Austin.
All right, boys and girls, get on close to your TV or your iPad or your cell phone this morning and pay attention to our children's message a little bit longer than typical. But what do we have but time during this time of quarantine? So get close. Lenny, Lucy, Rylan, Maggie, June, Cash, Nile, Holland, John Maddox, Rowdy Pete, Colton, Parker, I'm probably forgetting somebody, but everybody get close and watch your children's message this morning. Miss LaWanda's not here, obviously. Continue to pray for her and her family as she goes through this week. And she'll be back as soon as possible, and I know she wants to give Cash a hug as soon as she can. And I don't know which one is more likely to have the coronavirus, Cash or Miss LaWanda, but we'll leave that up to them, okay? What I want to talk to you about this morning is the coronavirus has probably caused you or your family to worry a little bit, Maybe you were worried you couldn't see your friends on the playground anymore because school was canceled. Maybe you were worried because your parents lost their job or couldn't go to work. Maybe you were worried because you had a grandparent or a great-grandparent who got the virus. You were worried that your friends were not going to be friends with you anymore because you couldn't see them. There's all kinds of worries. Even adults have worries. We have worries of our health, our finances, or our businesses if we couldn't get there. We've had a lot of worry in the world today, a lot of worry in our lives today because of this coronavirus. And what I want to talk to you about this morning is the Bible says, do not worry. If you and I, if we know Jesus and we know God and we have a personal relationship with them and we're Christians, what the Bible tells us, what God tells us is, in the grand scheme of things, we have nothing to worry about. Because one day everything is going to be perfect and it's going to be better than anything you've ever experienced here on earth. Yes, bad things will still happen to you. Bad things are still going to happen in your life and in your parents' life because we live in a broken world. But the thing we need to get out of this morning is we don't have anything to worry about because we know Jesus and we have God. And even though we may go through some bumps in the roads, we should not worry. And the way I want to present this to you this morning is, have you ever heard of Hakuna Matata? Some of you are probably sitting close to your TV and you're like, yeah, Hakuna Matata. That sounds familiar. Well, let me tell you where it's from. It's from The Lion King, okay? And it's a phrase or a motto that they use in The Lion King. And here in a second, we're going to show that to you in a video so that you can see what this phrase means and how it ties in to our children's message this morning. Brother Dalton, if you would, get us started.
Hakuna Matata. What a wonderful phrase.
Hakuna Matata. Ain't no peasant craze.
It means no worries for the rest of your days.
It's our problem-free philosophy.
Hakuna Matata.
Hakuna Matata?
Yeah, it's our motto.
What's the motto?
Nothing. What's the matter with you?
You know, kid, these two words will solve all your problems.
That's right. Take Pumbaa, for example. Why, when he was a young warthog.
When I was a young warthog.
Very nice.
Thanks.
He found his aroma lacked a certain appeal. He could clear the savannah after every meal.
I'm a sensitive soul, though I seem thick-skinned. And it hurt that my friends never stood downwind. And oh, the shame!
He was a shame!
What a change in my name!
Oh, what's your name?
And I got downhearted.
How'd you feel?
Every time that I...
Hey, Pumbaa, not in front of the kids.
Oh, sorry.
Hakuna Matata. What a wonderful phrase. Hakuna Matata. Ain't no passing craze.
Welcome to our humble home.
You live here?
We live wherever we want.
Yep, home is where your rump rests.
It's beautiful.
I'm starved.
I'm so hungry I could eat a whole zebra.
Ah, we're fresh out of zebra.
Any antelope?
Nuh-uh.
Hippo?
Nope. Listen, kid, if you live with us, you have to eat like us. Hey, this looks like a good spot to rustle up some grub.
Ew, what's that?
A grub. What's it look like?
Ew, gross. Mm.
Tastes like chicken.
Slimy yet satisfying.
These are rare delicacies.
Mm. Mm.
pecans with a very pleasant crunch.
You'll learn to love them.
I'm telling you, Kev, this is the great life. No rules, no responsibilities. Ooh, the little cream filled kind. And best of all, no worries. Well, kid?
Oh, well, Hakuna Matata. Slimy, yet satisfying.
That's it.
All right, boys and girls, so you see, you have nothing to worry about. Hakuna Matata. So when life throws you worries, or what I would call slimy worms, okay? When life throws you slimy worms, what you need to remember is Hakuna Matata, slimy yet satisfying. Let's pray. Father, we love you. We just ask that you touch these children with your hand, Lord, that you guide them in their young lives, that you will be with their parents and grandparents, and that you will give them the wisdom and guidance they need to raise these young people. We just pray that you'll be with Miss LaWanda and her family as they're going through some things this week, and that you'll bring her back here safe and sound and as soon as possible. We just thank you again for our time here this morning and the fact that we have the technology to put this on Facebook and in YouTube, and for young people to watch this at their home or in their recliner with the iPad or cell phone. We are so blessed, and we take it for granted each and every day, and we just thank you for that, Lord. We just ask you, forgive us where we fail you, and you'll be with the rest of our service. We pray all this in your name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Austin, for that. That was very interesting. Let's just remember that through the times that we're facing today, that we just need to have our faith in him and trust in him and leading us in the way that we should go. All the way, my Savior leads me. Savior leads me, what have I to ask beside? Can I doubt his tender mercy, who through life has been my guide? Heavenly peace divine is comfort, here by faith in him to dwell. For I know whate'er befall me, Jesus doeth all things well. For I know whate'er befall me, Jesus doeth all things well. All the way my Savior leads me, cheers each winding path I tread, gives me grace for every trial, feeds me with the living bread. Though my weary steps may falter, and my soul athirst may be, gushing from the rock before me, lo, a spring of joy I see. Gushing from the rock before me, lo, a spring of joy I see. All the way my Savior
me all the fullness of his love. Perfect rest to me is promised in my Father's house above. When my spirit glowed immortal, wings his flight to realms of day. This my song through endless ages, Jesus led me all the way. This my song through endless ages, Jesus led me all the way. This my song, Jesus led me all the way. Cast all your anxiety on him because he cares for you. Let's be mindful that God will take care of us. Be not dismayed, whatever betide, God will take care of you. Beneath his wings of love abide, God will take care of you. God will take care of you through every day or all the way. He will take care of you. God will take care of you. No matter what may be the test, God will take care of you. Lean weary one upon his breast, God will take care of you. God will take care of you through every day or all the way. He will take care of you. God will take care.
Amen. Thank you, Carolyn, for that beautiful selection, as well as putting America the Beautiful on there, which reminds you that this is Memorial Day weekend. You've been seeing on your screen. Remember and honor those that gave their life for the freedoms that we enjoy today. The song I'd like to sing this morning has to, I've always called it an evangelistical song, but I think in times that we're in, it's just a reminder of us every day that we talked a while ago in Scripture about cast your anxieties upon Him, because we're facing a lot of anxieties and trials and everything today. And we got to remember that He takes care of us and He'll see us through. If you go through any place in a store, anywhere, and you see people with your mask, or some of them don't have masks, but you can see their eyes either way, and there's a lot of anxiety in this world. People are really concerned about things going on, and we just got to rely on Him to just see us through. And we just want to remind ourselves that people need the Lord. Every day they pass me by, I can see it in their eyes. Empty people filled with care, headed who knows where. On they go through private pain, living fear to fear. Laughter hides their silent cries, only Jesus hears. People need sharing life with one who's lost. Through His love our hearts can feel all the grief they bear. They must hear the words of Father, we praise you for being the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And Lord, help us to rely on you for our strength every day. And ask now a blessing on Brother Vix. He brings your message. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.